civil unrest has a negative effect on economic growth, with mixed results, largely because politically, it can take various forms. With the severe looting and burning of malls and offices across the state, the impact on small and medium businesses will be strong, especially as the country has not fully recovered from the COVID-19 pandemic. Joining us via Zoom is Mokhtar Mohammed to share his thoughts on this. Thank you very much for joining us, Mr. Mohammed.
Thank you.
The looting and carnage in the last 24 hours, or maybe even 48, is beyond what words can describe. Can you let us or share with us what impact this will have on small and medium enterprises?
Well, I have to say, as a Nigerian, I've been heavy heart over what is happening in our country. It's not good for business, it's not good for anything, and especially business. And with where we're coming from an economy that's already suffering from a lot of issues. And coupled with this now, it's going to be a huge challenge for the government to be able to handle this, and also small businesses. Lagos State Chambers of Commerce said as far as 12 days of that protest, the demonstration of about 700 billion. Now, we're talking about 12 days. As I stand to be corrected, when Lagos is shut down, the economy of Nigeria is shut down. So as we are saying now, we're looking at an economy that is shut down for the past 24 hours. Not just Lagos, we're seeing the economy of Nigeria shut down for 24 hours, and like you said, 48 hours, coupled with lootings, especially of small and medium enterprise and those companies that gives jobs and to Nigeria. So if you go back yesterday, we saw the all share index of the Nigerian stock is seeing deep by 0.75%, and investors lost over 113.7 billion. So that is the effect that we are seeing, and we will not see this effect so much until we begin to get the report from the National Bureau of Statistics, and also quoted company begin to put up their results for us to see. It's a tough time for America. A lot of ingenuity. It will take a lot of confidence. It will take a lot of policies from the government to get our economy back in order. Already, we already have a shattered economy coming from the pandemic of COVID-19.
Okay, and also, you know, one other part of, you know, this conversation we shouldn't leave out is the insurance companies. How do you think they would also be able to step in, and, you know, how would it also affect them?
How many Nigerian companies are actually insured? How many SMEs are actually insured? Don't be talking about the SMEs. We talk about the big companies, when we talk about the banks, we talk about the big conglomerate of companies like that were attacked, those big ones. You can be talking about insurance policy, but when you talk about the SME, how many SMEs are able to stand on their own top less of having insurance? How do you talk of the trader that his shop was burgled in Okota, Lagos State? How do you talk about the trader that his shop also was burgled somewhere in Surulere? How does he or she be able to be compensated by insurance company? Even as individuals, how many individuals even have insurance policies? So if you look at that, the insurance company will be paying much, especially in terms of damages to those companies that were looted, and those companies also that were burnt down. But to the SME, it still will be borne on the SMEs, the entrepreneur, the founder, to begin to pick up his broken pieces to come back to business, because most of them are already facing a lot of funding challenges, talk less of having insurance. So, but when you look at the insurance sector, it's going to also hardly hit them, because they are going to pay a lot of premium this period because of the challenges of this crisis that has happened, especially to most of the big conglomerates that have been affected, and those conglomerates definitely have insurance policies.
Will this be, you know, motivation for those SMEs and those small business places to then patronize insurance companies at their level?
I think the problem with Nigerian insurance company goes beyond SMEs ready to not to patronize insurance company. I think it goes by the way insurance companies sometimes behave when it comes to claims, getting your claims. So it's a systematic problem, it's a fundamental problem. It takes a lot for you to even get your car insurance settled if you have issues. And then the SMEs looked at it, they tell you to bring this document, get a police report. So until the insurance company also come up with ways whereby it's easier for you to be attacked or you have issues that have to do with insurance, and they will step in on time before you see people begin to look at them, take them serious, and SMEs will want to patronize them. Because now if an SME shop that is boggled during the crisis, you are telling him to bring a police report, he cannot go to a police station, you are giving him time frame. If this is not reported in the next 30 days, he will lose his claim. So they need to come up with something. Maybe the insurance company, it is an avenue also for them to begin to come up with policy for SMEs, especially by and by what has happened now.
It's very possible some of these SMEs may not recover, you know, from what has happened, of course, dealing with, you know, the economic challenges of COVID-19 and then now losing all their goods to looting in the last 48 hours. It might be difficult for them to come back. What expert advice can you give, maybe from, you know, the side of the government, as we recover, of course, from the pandemic, inflation rates record high? What ways can the government or can we salvage all of this?
Unfortunately, we have a government that seems not to be bothered about what actually we have a government that have not said anything. We've not got any report from the presidency. So you can't be even thinking of what they want to do. But if I will say, and that's what I've been saying, even during the time we have the pandemic, we should be seeing a government that should be thinking of direct interventions, especially SMEs that have up to 3 or 4 people that they have employed. I think government should look at them, try to see how they can intervene to help them. I was saying this before the pandemic, and now with the riot, I think the government have to recover from challenges they are going through at the moment. So for me, as long as government has not come out categorically, even if the vice president have said that it will make sure justice will be mandated out to everybody in both sides. So we wait to see how they are going to help in business. Remember, the pandemic intervention has not even yield any results yet. So I wonder how this also will begin to yield results, because you are talking about an informal sector. You are not talking about a formal sector. Government easily intervene in the formal sector, but it's always difficult in the informal sectors. And we know why, because there's no data to be able to say who is an SME, how much of these SMEs was affected by this crisis. So that's a major challenge. Then we look at it by inflation. Of course, you expect inflation figures to go up in city like Lagos, because goods and services, especially that are coming outside of Lagos, have not been able to find their way into Lagos. And then those goods that are coming from outside of Lagos, also most of the perishable goods also will get spoiled on the way, because we don't even have a very robust storage system to bring these things inside. So when you're looking at it, the time that will be lost, and the individuals that will be affected, business that will be affected, when the NBC data comes in, especially for the last quarter of the year, we'll see the impact already. We'll see the impact of this crisis, because we're already seeing the impact of the COVID-19 on that. So we'll see another big impact, especially with what has happened. But what the SMEs should be doing is a challenging time for the SMEs. I think they need to re-strategize, need to begin to see how they can get easy funding from government or from individuals that they think, because getting funding even in the banks at this time is going to be very, very tough for the SME. So it means the SME need to change their strategy, need to get more investors into their companies, need to do things differently. And then the one that will definitely going to affect everybody, that means the SMEs maybe think to bring down labor. When you're talking about bringing it, but then you think to labor market. And I think that is one way, that's why I'm saying that the government should try to intervene and see whereby that they can give soft landing, especially to those employers that may lose their job, and the government can take it up and say, You don't have to sack them. We will do the payment for the next 6 months. Those are the type of direct intervention that help an economy in times of crisis.
What would you say to a business owner who has lost everything as it stands? I know of certain malls along Admiralty in Lekki that were looted and completely vandalized. To a business owner who has lost all their goods in the last 24 hours, what would you say to a person like that? In, of course, ways that they can get back to business. And then second, what is the possibility of loans from places like the Bank of Industry at a time like this? Can they step in? Can they assist some of these business owners with loans to get back to business?
It's tough. It's tough what you can tell them at this moment. It's very, very, very tough. You're talking of billions of naira lost. You're talking about facilities destroyed. You're talking about a lot of things. It's a tough time for them. Will the Bank of Industry come in? I think the Lagos State government should come bring up their ingenuity in here by setting up a fund. They set up funds for victims of the crisis. I think they should go a step further and see if they can set up fund for businesses that have been affected, especially SMEs. And to see how they can help these companies, these businesses that have been affected by this crisis to come back. Because without government help, that might just be the death of most of all these businesses. Because you're talking, most of these businesses can even be that the owners of this business are even have loans from banks. They got the money from banks, and so it causes also they need to discuss with the bank and everything. If you look about the Bank of Industry. You know that we were very tough times in the industry business based on funding for a particular sector. But I don't think they have a funding for emergency or for crisis like this. I think that is where they would really need to look at and see if they will be able to help the government in that area, or the government will be able to help the Bank of Industry with funds for crisis management. And if that comes, I think businesses will recover. But if we have to look at our experiences with the intervention of COVID, sure what to expect.
Under the current,
it might not be the same of saying the small business owners, the company that have lost a lot during this crisis, will still be the one to pick their breaking pieces and get back to business. Because in this country, it has been proven that government has not intervened in businesses to help businesses grow in time of crisis. What government always think about is the civil service, the civil servants, and how to help them to put food on their table. They don't look at the private sector on how to bring back the social sector back to business, especially when things like this happen. But maybe we could see a change in that this time, because it's a crisis that is getting world attention. And I think the government will want to clothe himself in glory, because as it stands now, they are really at the receiving end from every part of the world.
Mokhtar Mohammed, thank you so much for your thoughts. Looking forward to another conversation. It's pretty interesting.
It's always a pleasure being on TV.